The newly constituted Monetary Policy Committee of the RBI has announced its monetary policy decisions. After 3 days of deliberations, they have voted unanimously and rates now remain unchanged. The repo rate remains unchanged at 4%. Governor Shaktikant Das also reiterated the RBI's stance as being accommodative. He said that this is going to be the case for as long as needed. But more importantly, the RBI has said that the GDP growth will break out of contraction and turn positive by Q4. Let's take that to Purva Chitnis and Sakshi Bajaj. First to you, Purva. Interestingly, break this down for us and please talk a little bit also about the turn in the wind that the RBI governor was speaking about. He said that employee sentiment is changing. What do you have for us?
Well, in fact, the RBI has announced this policy after a 1 week delay. And here the RBI governor has said that there are two important points that he made. One is on inflation, another one is on the growth target. Well, as far as the inflation is concerned, right now we are seeing that the inflation is quite high at this point of time. It is the RBI's target is 4%. Plus or minus 2% on that. So right now the inflation is over 6.5%, and RBI says that, you know, even for September month, it expects to see a high inflation, but towards the end of this quarter, the inflation will come down. That is an important point that the RBI has made. Also, if we talk about growth, now for the RBI has given a growth target for this entire year. Now for the financial year 2021, the RBI says that the growth target that the RBI sees is a negative 9.5%. Now that is something that is also very crucial, because RBI has now given out a growth target, because since the pandemic began, the RBI did not reveal a figure that they would like to, that they see the inflation, that the growth, where they see the growth. But now they have said that the growth for the entire financial year is going to be a negative 9.5%. But definitely for the next quarter, which is the fourth quarter, that is January to March, they say that the growth can turn positive. But for the overall year, the growth expected is negative 9.5%. Now, these are the two key points that the RBI made. And they also said that, you know, overall, globally also, things are changing around. Even India and Indian economy, if we talk about, things are changing around. As I mentioned, the inflation is expected to get better in the next quarter.
Right.
Also, the RBI says that the business environment is also expected to improve in the next quarter. The RBI said that, you know, people are started going back to work, the migrants are started returning back to the cities. So these are certain points in the economy that the RBI says are positive. And going forward, the RBI says, since the overall global economy is also turning around,
right,
Indian economy is also expected to turn around. So these
right
are some of the key points that the RBI made in that policy meet.
Right, thank you. I'm going to take that to Sakshi. Sakshi, the RBI governor has said that the Indian economy is entering into a decisive phase in its fight against the pandemic. And he mm-hmm spoke about how people's expectations were changing. Is this some light at the end of the tunnel? As he said, consumer sentiment is mending. The RBI has also announced steps to boost liquidity. How have the markets reacted?
Absolutely. Well, the markets have been cheering on. The first initial reaction from the markets is, of course, our benchmark indices are firmly in the green. Remember, before the policy announcement, the markets were toggling between trading marginally in the red or marginally in the green, but now they're firmly in the green. So that's as far as the market reaction is concerned. Of course, the rate-sensitive stocks, autos and banking stocks, will need to be looked at closely. They were also trading green when we last checked. We would like to, of course, now ask our experts, like you mentioned, the fact that barring the GDP growth projection and inflation projections, the RBI did announce a whole host of new measures. New measures with regards to liquidity, new measures with regards to financial inclusion. So I'd like to go to Mr. Nasir Salim, who's the managing partner at Flexi Capital, and his take on all these new measures announced today.
Fairly some of the positive steps taken by the RBI. You know, as far as the, I heard your panelists also in your reporting saying that accommodative stand was something which was expected.
Mm-hmm.
I think yes, broadly because of headline inflation, looking at where it was, closer and much above the expected levels, which is the comfort level of 4% and beyond. So it was closer to 6%. Therefore, I think the accommodative stand was something which is expected. But I think here's my quick point, Sakshi. I think as far as RBI is concerned, you know, they have again time and again proved to us that repo rate cuts and rate cuts are not the only tools that they have. They have many more available tools, such as the OMOs, which they've again announced. And since your question was very clearly was, what have they done? So I think clearly, as far as OMOs are concerned, which is open market operations, they have now said they will be pumping in more OMOs depending on how the interest rates move and to support liquidity infusion in the economy. I think the other thing very clearly is Operation Twist. Again, they've said that they will be looking at infusing liquidity through Operation Twist, through OMOs. And a very specific requirement, and I must tell you, and I've written this down also, Sakshi, where they brought in and spoke about is an on-tap TLTRO. Now, TLTRO is basically targeted long-term repo operations, right, which is done for a specific purpose. And in this case, they've said they will do on-tap TLTROs for 3 years, which will be linked and to the effect of 1 lakh crore, which is, again, infusing liquidity in the system because, you know, they can't look at rate cuts until inflation starts to come down. I think that is going to be a great, great support, which is going to help infuse liquidity in the system. The other thing very clearly is they're saying that inflation will look at should come down between Q3 and Q4. On the retail perspective, which is for you and me and for a lot of existing seamless efficiency of banking, I think the other very good thing that they've done is last year in December, they had done that for the NEFT transactions. Now, Sakshi, from a financial inclusion perspective, which was your question, I think RTGS has been now done, which will be done from December 2020. It's going to be 24/7. So you can do an RTGS, which is a real-time gross settlement. I'm sure you and me all have used it at some point in time of our lives. RTGS becomes 24/7, which again talks about more quicker transfer of funds, more inclusion, and will bring in also a sense of efficiency in terms of transfer of funds. I think one last thing also in terms of support, a very brave move by the RBI, was on account of the RBI now talking about OMOs to support OMOs for state level, for state bank loans. I think that is again something which has been a very brave step taken by the RBI. Please remember, states' situation is not looking very good. It's obviously looking a little dicey in terms of their revenue collection. They've also had impacts on GST collections. Mm-hmm. Therefore, RBI coming forward and taking that step and saying we will support OMO for state loans as well is a welcome step at this point of time.
All right. That's as far as liquidity and all the new measures are concerned. Now, I'd like to ask you, as far as the RBI governor saying that consumer confidence is upbeat at the moment, saying that revival is now the key focus. Now, many experts believe this could just be pent-up demand. This could just be demand ahead of the festive season. So how would you as an expert feel that we can really make sure of this revival and this long-term journey towards growth?
Sakshi, look, there has to be, obviously, there was COVID fatigue, you know, which all of us have experienced, mm-hmm. and that is available as far as the numbers also concerned, coupled with pent-up demand. So you will see certain phases of great number recovery. But having said that, I think, you know, the fact of the matter is that today, if we look at the situation as far as March and April is concerned, I want to take back all your viewers to that level, there was a fear psychosis. That fear is coming down. Now, when fear comes down, you start looking at spending. So there is consumer discretionary, which is picking up, Sakshi, the way it is, and it should pick up going forward. The only thing right now, I think the green shoots that the RBI governor was mentioning clearly was in terms of certain sectors. And I think that is something which is very, very important. Certain sectors are agriculture. The agricultural economy stands to be resilient. You know, it has been less impacted on account of COVID, as we know. And I think also, you know, certain other sectors such as pharma, IT. I think mm-hmm. these are sunrise sectors which will continue to support, followed by consumer distribution. I'll give you a small example, Sakshi. If you look at the August and September number for an automobile company like Maruti Suzuki, they've mm-hmm. had higher turnover as compared to last year of 2019, same period. Right. So the point is, two-wheeler also is a great example where we'll see some recovery. So mm-hmm. these are clearly signs of recovery on account of the psychosis, fear psychosis is decreasing. Coupled with that, we have also the Diwali season coming up. Mm-hmm. As I said, people are now, there is COVID fatigue. They would wish to want to go out. And we can see that consumer discretionary spending also happening as we move out on the roads and streets.
Absolutely.
So I think the RBI governor was looking at that.
Absolutely. I'd also like to go to Mr. Sunil Alag, who is an independent business consultant, and take this to you as well, sir. So could this revival and this upbeat consumer sentiment be just pent-up demand, be people recovering from the COVID fatigue, from the pandemic fatigue, looking out to head out, and of course shop ahead of the festive season? And it's interesting he mentioned auto sales, as many experts believe that this could all just be near-term cheer ahead of the festive season. And in reality, the picture may be very different. So what do you have to say about that? Mr. Sunil Alag, can you hear me?
Who are you? Who are you asking me?
Yes, Mr. Sunil Alag. Yes, this is for you.
Yeah, okay. Now, all I can say is, look, I've been saying that, look, ultimately, because of the festive season and pent-up demand, everything is going to look good. The question that we have to worry about is to sustain that growth. See, once the festive demand is over, how do you sustain it? And I think that is the key thing starting from January, because whatever happens in the fourth quarter will be the starting point for all of us in 21-22. Forget about the past, forget about what we are at, but the last quarter, if we are showing some signs of revival, then that will be great. And the only way, I've been saying it ad nauseum, the only way which seems to be not in the hands of the RBI, because we've got a very practical and very positive RBI governor right now. And the thing is, it lies with, they can come up with the macro policy, but the micro policy lies with the government. And unless they put money in the hands of the consumer, I think sustaining will become a little difficult, because at this point of time, do not get carried away with the euphoria that is coming up because of the festive season. Mm-hmm. It's the question of sustaining. And I've been saying, unless you give money in the hands of the consumer, does not have to be direct. You have to incentivize consumers to spend. You have to tell them that if they spend money on cars, they spend money on travel, they will get a tax rebate on it. Then that way you're not putting money in their hands, but you're incentivizing them to spend. And that will become very, very critical as far as I'm concerned, because ultimately when you talk about all kinds of shapes of K-shaped, U-shaped and everything else, it's the Prime Minister is going to go and do things where he has taken care of the poor and the agricultural sector, which is very important. He has to now look at the demand side. He's looked at the supply side very well. Mm-hmm. And now is the time for the demand side to be looked at, because 300 million people in the middle income group, in urban centers and tier one cities and all, they are just waiting for something to be given to them. And that's the only step which I think they are faltering on. And if they do that, then they will sustain this growth. The green shoots will then become plants. If you don't do that, then you've got a big, big problem at the moment.
And all right. So that's sustained where growth and, of course, demand revival, the need of the hour. Thank you so much, Mr. Sunil Alag and Mr. Nasir Salim, for joining us for this discussion. We'll take a short break and be back with more headlines just after a short while.